Hello everybody, in this video we shall see about the important relationship between our digestive activity and rheumatoid arthritis. Ayurveda says indigestion is one of the main reason for diseases such as rheumatoid arthritis. In the first instance it may seem as if indigestion may not be a big deal after all, but like Ayurveda says, many of the recent medical researches have also proven the same fact that there is a great important relationship between rheumatoid arthritis and digestive activity, which I will also share in the later part of this video. First thing is that every rheumatoid patient should first know that in his body he needs to keep his digestion in a healthy manner and he needs to control the excess of vata aggravation, that should be under control. These two factors are very important, and this every patient should understand it clearly. Why? Because in the initial stages of rheumatoid arthritis, normally we don't give much attention to our digestion and other activities, because by taking painkiller the pain is almost completely gone, so we think that we are completely free from the disease, so we can take our normal food and carry on with our regular work and again follow our the old unhealthy lifestyle itself. Due to this, what happens as years go by, slowly the pain in the joints starts increasing and starts to spread, and after some time even the joints started to bend and there is more complications, and on the other side even the number of medicines, the dosage of medicines also keep on increasing. So and hence, to avoid these kind of unnecessary complications and sufferings, a rheumatoid patient should always maintain a healthy digestion and control the vata level in his body. First let me tell how these two factors are going to disturb or cause problem in rheumatoid arthritis. See this digestion. Normally when we eat food, when our appetite is good, the food gets digested properly. If our digestion is a bit low, what happens? The food will not get digested properly. For example, imagine you are cooking something in the kitchen. You kept the right amount of fire in the stove. Suppose the fire is reduced to half. What happens? Will the food get cooked properly? No. Half it will be cooked, half will not get cooked. Same thing will happen even in our body also. When our digestive activity is low and we keep eating normal food, what happens? A few of it will get digested, a few of it will remain undigested. Normally in a healthy person, what happens if the food is not getting digested properly, the undigested portion will normally get eliminated from the body. But when the vata level is a little bit high in the body, what happens, this normal expulsion of waste will not happen. Instead of this vata will push the undigested toxins into the body. This is the nature of vata. When it is normal, it will move in the normal route. When it's increased, it will start moving in all abnormal routes, just like a river. As long as the water is in the normal level, the river will keep flowing within its area. Suppose if there is flooding, what happens? The water starts to move inside the cities and towns, and along with it will bring all the other dust particles also into the town. Same thing. Now here, because of low activity of digestion and our unhealthy food habits, like we are eating too fast, not chewing and swallowing it properly, drinking too much of water in between, again eating without proper consideration to our appetite. So what happens, gradually the amount of undigested toxins starts building up, and because of this increased vata in the body, all these toxins is being pushed into our system and it starts circulating in the blood, and gradually these toxins will get lodged in the joints and start producing the pain and swellings. This is what is being described according to Ayurveda. Now the same things, the concept is same, the process is same, only it is told in a different language. That is what we see in the recent research activities. That is, various researches have been done. What they are telling is that in many rheumatoid patients, on analyzing it is observed that most patients have increased intestinal permeability in them, and also they have gut dysbiosis or dysbiotic syndrome. So two factors are common in rheumatoid arthritis patients under new research activities. That is increased intestinal permeability. What this actually means is, normally in our intestines, it's not just simply open. The food which we eat cannot easily enter into the bloodstream. The intestines have some gate and lock mechanism, which is tightly guarded. So only which food which is required, the nutrients which is required for our body will be absorbed. The harmful toxins or undigested toxins and bacteria, virus and all will not be allowed to enter into our system, as long as the intestinal permeability is normal. But in rheumatoid patients, we see an increased intestinal abnormality. So what happens, that gate and lock mechanism is not effective. It is a bit more open. So what happens, obviously more amount of undigested toxins are able to easily enter into our body. This is one reason. Another reason they are telling us, gut dysbiosis. That is due to the imbalance in the bacterial flora in our digestive tract. That is, normally we think we are only digesting the food which we eat, but it is not so. We are able to digest only a part of it. The majority of it is actually being digested with the help of the bacteria in our digestive tract. So when there is imbalance in this bacterial population, what happens? We are unable to digest our food properly. So gradually there is more amount of indigestion, more amount of toxins, and due to this increased intestinal permeability, all this toxin slowly enters into the system. And these two factors have been associated with a lot of autoimmune diseases, including rheumatoid arthritis. With more research activities, we will be getting more knowledge on this particular area. I'm just telling this because what has been told in Ayurveda thousands of years ago, the same concept, now we are getting more and more light into that areas. That is the thing we need to consider here. So hence what happens? A rheumatoid patient should maintain a healthy digestion and control the vata level in his body. Hence, a rheumatoid patient, to maintain a healthy digestion, what he needs to do is, in the morning, instead of tea or coffee, he can take one glass of milk with a little bit of dry ginger powder and dry coriander seeds powder. And for that, for taste, he can have a little bit of palm jaggery or palm sugar with it. This is in the morning instead of tea or coffee. In the evening, he can either take green tea or milk with turmeric powder and palm jaggery. So these two simple remedies will help to maintain a proper digestion. Apart from that, the food which he takes should be of a light in quality. That is, it should be easy to digest. Let him take maximum of raw fruits and vegetables. If it is a cooked food, it should be something which is light, or that is easy to digest. And then the quantity of food, it should never cross more than 3/4 of his capacity. Suppose a patient would normally eat 4 chapatis, then he should stop with 3 chapatis. Then the digestion will be in a proper manner. Again, even eating also, he should eat in a very slow and calm manner. Chew the food nicely and then swallow it. These simple measures will help to maintain a proper digestion. Apart from that, to control the vata in his body, always remember, to control vata, you have to control your breathing. So what a person can do is, daily in the morning and evening, just for 10 minutes in empty stomach, let him sit in a comfortable position and observe his breathing pattern. Let him inhale slowly and exhale slowly. During this inhalation and exhalation, let him visualize his joints. Let him please visualize it as, all the pain has gone, the swellings have gone, you are able to flex and move your joints freely. You are able to do the work, all the work as normally as you used to do before. Just visualize this, enjoy it and visualize this. So this will help to a great extent in controlling the vata aggravation in your body. Along with these food habits, when you take medicines, Ayurvedic medicines, with the consultation of an Ayurvedic doctor, because most Ayurvedic medicines which are prescribed for rheumatoid arthritis have these two qualities. That is, these medicines have the nature of controlling the excess of vata and also regulating your digestion. So hence, when you take Ayurvedic medicines along with a proper food habit, you will be able to control rheumatoid arthritis in a very effective manner. Thank you.